I mentioned earlier that rather than coming in and manually adding the tags to these PyPoint data references, what if we built into our element template a way to automatically generate this tag name based on some sort of substitution parameter? So if we look back at our tag list, we see that, for example, the indoor temperature has a three-digit code in it, and that the first digit of that code corresponds very nicely to the actual zone number. For which that tag corresponds. So then all we need is a substitution parameter that would allow us to somehow plug in the zone number for this first digit, and we could generically generate our tag names through the template. Well, fortunately for us, we do have a zone number attribute that returns the zone number, so all we have to do is figure out the correct substitution parameter to bring the zone number and substitute it in for this first digit here. So I'll go ahead and delete that first digit. And I know that the substitution parameter that we want would be percent at zone number percent. So essentially I've put the attribute name zone number inside of percentage marks and then put the at sign between the first percentage mark and the beginning of the attribute name. So if we jump to the PSE user manual real quick, we see that for a reference attribute value, when configuring a PyPoint data reference, the proper syntax is going to be percent at the attribute name and then another percent. So that's exactly what we did here. So if we just put say percent attribute, that would give us the name of the owning attribute, which in this case would be indoor temperature. But like I said, we want to use this percent at zone number percent. So let's go ahead and check this in and we'll see how it's working. Now if we check the indoor temperature for zone 1, everything looks fine. Zone 2 and zone 3, everything looks fine. But as we mentioned earlier, we actually got zone 2 and zone 3 by doing a manual override. And just to drive this point home, I'll go in the library and let me just cut this substitution parameter. And I'll just put that percent attribute percent again. So now this substitution parameter should return the name indoor temperature. If I check that in and go back to my elements, you see it's had no effect on zone 3. It's still using the T300 tag that we specified earlier. Zone 2 is using the T200 tag. But when we get to zone 1, we get this warning about the pi point not being found. And you can see the tag name it's trying to resolve is OSIsoft HVAC sim.t indoor temperature 00.pv. So again, it used that substitution parameter for the attribute name that we specified and put it in with the rest of the string to try and create a tag name. But since this tag does not exist on our PyData archive, the AF server can't find it. So let's go ahead and look at zone 2. As I stated, we kind of did an manual override by stating the tag explicitly. If I wanted to use the template instead, I can right-click on an attribute and select the option for reset to template. And what this is going to do is it's going to take this attribute and make it use whatever configuration string I have specified in the template. So let's go ahead and do that, and you see I get the same error about the tag not being found. And we'll do that for number 3. And we get the same issue. So let's go ahead and check that in. I'll go back to my library. And here I'll go ahead and correct this substitution parameter. check that change in. And if we go back to our elements, we'll see now the substitution is working correctly. I'm getting T300 here because it's substituting in the zone number 3. Zone 2 is again using the T200 tag. And zone 1 is using the T100 tag. So let's go ahead and update our thermostat settings as well. So again, I'll delete this 1 and put in my substitution parameter. Check that in, and then we'll jump back to our elements and make sure all our tags look fine. So T109, T209, T309. Okay. So that's how we can, one, use substitution parameters to help us generically generate tag names through the template. And two, if we have a template, or if we have an element that's not using the configuration string specified in the template and we would like it to use what's in the template, we can always right-click on that attribute and select Reset to Template. And again, I'll finish up by checking in all my work.